Hi guys, thanks for checking back in for another episode of Sez the Vet. A very topical question today, can my sheep actually recover from facial eczema? There's a lot online saying that it's not truly treatable. People want to know, is this really true? Great question, and yes, I can see the confusion because there are different approaches, and it comes down really to how you're defining treatable. I'll assume that people watching this understand what facial eczema is. If you want a fully in-depth explanation, I will link an episode here for you. But in short, it's a summertime disease here in New Zealand where fungus growing on the grass produces a toxin that damages the liver. So they go down with liver failure. And one of the signs of liver failure is sensitivity to sunlight. So they get sunburned, and sometimes really severely. And that's because there is a compound in the grass that causes sensitivity of the skin, and usually the liver gets rid of it. So when the liver can't do its job, we see that compound building up in the skin and damaging it. So can you treat the condition? Well, yes, you can. Can you get complete resolution? Might be a slightly different story. What we have to do for treatment is to remove them from the toxin, of course, give them zinc, which stops the toxin from further absorbing in the stomach, and then take care of their welfare, pain relief, antihistamines, zinc sunscreen, keep them in the shade. Of course, guys, do not underestimate what, you know, severe sunburn is like. If they're really severely sunburned, it doesn't matter if it's treatable. It might actually just be kinder to euthanize them anyway, because there's a lot of suffering involved there. Liver disease as well, which is underlying that sunburn, is also very painful and really wreaks havoc on the body. So they'll be feeling nauseous, their brain will be acting funny. It's not a fun time at all. When people say it's not treatable, they're referring to how damaged the liver is. So basically, our treatment is just stopping any further damage to allow the liver to regenerate. And the liver does have a phenomenal ability to regenerate, to rebuild itself. That's how we get away with donating big parts of our liver. It grows back. But when the liver is too damaged, it forms a lot of scar tissue. We call this cirrhosis of the liver. And big parts of the liver can be permanently and irreparably damaged. So if you catch it very early and go full haul with treatment, so everything that we just did, as well as fluid therapy, you might have it bounce back completely. Fluid therapy, I haven't mentioned yet, fluid therapy is the hallmark of supporting the liver in recovery, right? So a pet cat or dog, or even pet ruminants that I work with, will often be hospitalized and be put on a fluid drip straight into the vein to flush that liver, to flush the toxins, to improve blood flow to the liver, to make sure the liver's getting all the oxygen it needs to recover and give it the best fighting chance. Unfortunately, out in the paddock, all we're usually doing in a farm situation is taking them off the grass and giving them zinc, as well as pain relief and antihistamines, of course. So in that situation, it's really anyone's guess how badly damaged that liver is. Okay, the way that we know how bad the liver is damaged and how it's responding to treatment is through repeated blood tests. So an initial blood test and then repeating that blood test to watch what the liver is doing and how well it's regenerating. So the severity of the damage matters, the extent of your treatment matters, and if it's too little too late and that liver is really scarified, no, she will not fully recover. Now, the other discrepancy in what we mean by fully recover, and the reason that there might be conflicting information out there, is in, you know, how we're defining fully recover. What does it mean to fully recover? So in a pet, she may look like she's fully recovered. If she's well fed, she's not used for breeding, she's really taken care of as a little individual, she may live a long and happy life. Okay, she doesn't necessarily know that she's got underlying liver damage there. So in that case, we would call that fully recovered. Yes, treatment is worthwhile, she can live a long and happy life. But the same ewe on a farm, they may well notice that she doesn't get pregnant as easily. She produces less milk for her lambs. She goes down with other diseases quicker and is slaughtered at an early age. She loses weight. And can't do as well on what, you know, the food that she normally would do well on. So all I mean here is that it also depends on what demands we're putting on her body. So yes, there is often residual damage from facial eczema, and certainly I do not advocate leaving an animal to suffer with a hopeful wait and see attitude simply because she's a pet. If she's really suffering, she needs veterinary attention to make sure her welfare is taken well care of, or she needs to be humanely euthanized. And arguably the most important thing to understand here is that this is an iceberg disease. So if you see one with sunburn, there will be another at least handful of sheep, another 5 to 10 that have underlying liver damage that just aren't showing it outwardly yet. So get your zinc in, get them off the pasture, get them onto safe pasture. You can get your grass samples into the vet to do a spore count on those samples so they can tell you which of your paddocks are safer than the others. Otherwise, get your zinc in, get them off the pasture, up the fluids, protect everyone. All right, guys, I'm gonna leave it there. Thanks for the great question. Don't forget to thumbs up, comment away to let me know you appreciated it. Subscribe to catch the next one, and I'll see you there. Bye-bye.